Hi guys, this is Dr. Vstrom and this is another video from my brake series, and it is actually a quick how-to guide to replace the front and the rear brake pads on your motorcycle. Ideally, I suggest that you follow a more detailed maintenance of also cleaning and lubing your calipers, which is a video up here. But if you still feel that you just want to very fast replace the brake pads, then this is the video for you. Make sure to check the rest of the videos from my brake series up here and keep your braking system at top performance. As a way to say a small thanks for the effort of this channel for all these years, please visit my new YouTube channel. It's called Dreamcatcher. It's available up here. And why not subscribe to support my effort, my overall effort as a content creator. Although the content of this new channel is a bit different than motorcycles, subscribing takes only 1 second. It's literally a click of a button. It's completely free. You don't have any obligations, but at the end of the day, it will make a huge difference for me. So thanks for this. Now back to our video. This video is demonstrating on a Vstrom, obviously, but you can apply this technique to almost all motorcycles out there. Please note that I cannot be held responsible for your personal work in following these steps. If you feel that you're not confident enough, you should probably contact your dealer. For all sensitive items like brakes and other important maintenance tasks. For this maintenance task, you will need the following items: a torque wrench covering a range of 17 to 39 Newton meters, an Allen socket of size 5, a flat screwdriver, a wrench with an extension, a pick to remove the R clips from the calipers, sockets of sizes 8, 12, and 14. And optionally cotton buds, a steel wool for the retaining pins, gloves, copper grease, high temperature grease, and silicone grease, and last but not least, a brush. Let's move to the front brake pads.
I have already serviced the other side and deliberately selected to demonstrate on this side, because although the front, right and left calipers on this motorcycle are installed symmetrically, and therefore the removal reinstallation procedure is more or less the same, from this right side there is the exception of the ABS sensor cable, which is held by this metal bracket. You need a socket of size 8, undo this small bolt, use a wrench with a socket of size 14 and undo each bolt a few turns at a time. Remove each bolt. So this is our caliper, and this is the reason why I specifically mentioned to use a low table or a bungee cord, so that you can securely leave the caliper to be supported. From this point on, we enter the do not press the brake lever zone. Now let's check how worn the brake pads are by observing the groove limit lines in the pad material. The groove limit lines in the pad material are these lines, and besides being used to indicate the wear, they are also used to disperse water. When these lines have disappeared, it's time to replace the pads. Otherwise, there is a serious risk of ruining your rotor or brake disc. Besides the groove limit lines on the brake pads, you can tell a lot by observing the brake pad wear patterns. For wear patterns, These were patterns shown now on your screen. Consult on them and identify whether or not they are wearing evenly in a straight line and as expected, or if they have some weird pattern that indicates that there might be a problem with your caliper functioning. Okay, so the first step is to remove the little arc clip which holds the retainer or pad mounting pin. To do this, we use a special pick tool and remove. It's time to remove the brake pad retaining pin, like so. So you remove the R clip, you remove the retaining pin, and then you twist the outer brake pad like so and slide it out. The second one, you just pull it out.
An SOS item and a very important note for you who want to replace your brake pads is that we never throw away the back plates of the old brake pads. We will definitely need them, assuming that they are in a good state, to install the new brake pads. So do not throw them away.
The next step is to assemble the brake pads, and in order to do this and to put the back plates or the metal plates back, we will also use a small quantity of special grease. Put back the metal back plate or the seam or whatever you call it. So just grab the top. Passing on to the second and inner brake pad. Take the metal back plate or seam and insert it, and as before, take a cotton bud and wipe off any excess grease to leave a dry backside. As you can see, this is the inner brake pad and this is the movement it makes on top of the spring. If you can hear this sound, it comes in contact in this area and here. So apply where metal and metal comes in contact, as we said here, like so.
Please note that if any of the retaining pins are rusted or a bit deformed, you can try to smooth the surface with the steel wool in our optional items, but if they are very damaged, it's better that you replace them.
The next step is to apply the same high temperature lubricant on this sliding pin or on this pin where the brake pads are sliding. Once done, then you insert the second outer brake pad, obviously with the brake material to the inside, facing the inside. Insert this on this pin, rotate, and let it sit. A very important thing to take into consideration is that this metal spring has got an edge here, which is a stop, and when the outer pad rotates, it stops here. So make sure that the outer pad, its surface comes in contact here, and you don't put it from the inner side of the stop. So like so, you see, if I put pressure from here, it stops. The next step is to insert the retaining pin back into place. For this you need to pressure down the outer brake pad and it goes into place. After sliding in the lubricated retaining pin, the last step is to put back the R clip. The flat side goes on the bottom, so you need to align the retaining pin. It has got one hole, so you need to twist it until you see the opening so that the R clip goes back inside. Like so. Next step, after we have placed the caliper or we have mounted the caliper on the disc, move the ABS sensor cable aside and insert the first mounting bolt, which we also have applied copper grease or anti-seize compound. Next, it's the bottom mounting bolt. Similarly, we have applied anti-seize compound. Next, use your 14 socket to tighten a bit the mounting bolts by hand. The next step is to tighten the caliper mounting bolts to the specified torque, which for the front calipers is 39 Newton meters. And the bottom one. And that's it. Okay, so the last part now is to tighten and put in place the metal bracket for the ABS sensor cable. The socket that we need is 8, and just snag it a bit. And that's it. We're done.
That's the end of another video. Hope it was useful as the previous ones. Thanks for watching, and as always, ride safe. And last but not least, don't forget to check my new YouTube channel, and why not subscribe? Thanks.